Okay, so here's a little example that I think is useful to work through. So what is the C code going to print? So we have some declarations of integers and some pointers here. And so what we're going to do in this course is we're going to draw pictures of memory. And so these first three variables, we'll represent these as just being three boxes in memory. And we're going to label these boxes with the name of the variable, so A, B, and C. And I'm also going to mark the types of each of these variables. So in any case, the part that's inside of the rectangle, that's the only part that's actually stored in the system. The names are just labels, and the types are also just information about these spots in memory. So we initialize A to 42, we initialize B to 7, and we initialize C to 999. So this is what would be stored in the system after these first three declarations here. And again, it's important to note that the only things that are actually stored in the system in memory are these values, the things inside of the boxes. But we're going to track the names and the types just to help trace through this code and understand what's going on. Okay, so we also declare two, so if we look over here, we have declared our A, B, and C, but we also have two pointer variables, so T and U. So let's draw those as well. So those are just regular variables. They are allocated in memory. They are local here, presumably, to whatever function we're working with. So the name of one is T and the other is U. Their types, however, are going to be int star, denoting that they are pointers to an integer. And we get that information just by looking at the declaration. So just as A is declared to be an int, T is declared to be an int star. We have initialized T to be the address of A. So whatever the address of this particular memory location is in memory, that is what the value of T is going to be. And so we generally denote these pointers because we don't know the actual numbers of the memory addresses, and that's not actually terribly important. So generally we draw these as arrows. And so this indicates that T is now a pointer to A. The value of T, the actual value that is stored in this memory location, is the address of this memory location. You'll notice over here that we're also initializing U, but we're initializing it to null, meaning that it's not currently a pointer to anything. There are a couple of different ways to denote that. I like using this notation here. So this is what the memory is going to look like after this first set of declarations here. And so this line here that prints A and star T, well, A is just going to be 42, and star T, well, we're going to dereference T, so T is a pointer, we're going to dereference it, and we're going to take whatever value it's pointing to. So this is going to print 42, 42.